Great Bulldogs. Hello, everyone. I'm Jim Roberts with Bob Stevens. There's the kickoff. Stanley Gardner, number 85, an upback, takes it for the Drake Bulldogs, and activity is underway. Bob Stevens, Drake is 2-5, and the Golden Hurricane on with a 5-1 record.
Two teams pushing the elevator button and going the other way. TU, of course, has won 4 in a row. They're on a definite upside. Drake has lost 4 of their last 5 ball games and are having some trouble, but they've got a high-powered offense. We'll see it work right now.
Number 26, Samero Ware, is the one to keep an eye on for Drake. The quarterback is Yagelski, number 19. Boxes it out to Ware. He's across the 40. Not catch at the 43-yard line with number 32, Robert Estes.
Samero Ware likes to catch the ball out of the backfield. 24 catches coming into the ball game. As you see, Tulsa's defensive line, Blankenship, Lilly, Bruner, Baldwin, and Pendleton across the front. The linebackers, Bjorkman and Abbott. And in the secondary, Cooper, Dennis, Estes, and Beasley. It's a secondary that's going to be tested quite a bit tonight.
Pickup of 8 yards, second down and 2 for Drake. Move a tight end over on the other side, put somebody in motion. Drake Bulldogs with Yagelski, the quarterback. Here's the handoff to Amaro Ware. He's averaging 106.6 yards per ball game. Robert Estes, the cornerback, has 34 tackles on the year.
Can have a 17-1 lead in the all-time series.
Yagelski is back to throw, eludes the would-be tackler, and tosses it up. Incomplete. Drake moving from north to south. They won the toss, chose to receive. TU with a slight win to their back. Amaro Ware, number 26, takes it up to midfield at the 50-yard line.
Ware breaking the first.
34, and he was just 31 yards shy of tying coming in. Here's Yagelski back to throw on 3rd and 6, dumps it out to Ware, complete. He can do it all, but he is ending up about a yard to 2 yards shy of the first down. And the last week against SIU, 2 interceptions, off to go, and in the ball game to punt is Tom Miller. Not a very good average at 33.4, but he has excellent hang time. Gets it up in the air just like that when it's wobbly, but there's not too many run backs. There won't be anyway because it's out of bounds, and they'll play it from the around the neighborhood of the 22 to 25-yard line.
The Hurricane offensive line, Kirk Phillips, the split end. The guys in the middle, Pearson, Kaspersky, Imes, Cox, and Abramowitz. You see the backfield with Skipast at quarterback, Gunner and Lacey, the running backs. In
they put a man in motion. Steinauer switches tight end spots, goes to the right side of the line. The handoff coming to number 22, Michael Gunner. And Gunner is stopped for about a 1 yard loss by number 71, James Markert.
They're going to give him 1 yard worth of forward progress. As you see, the Drake defensive line, Lyons, Barnett, Hansen, great player on the nose, Markert and Panazzo. The linebackers are Hall and Dunnigan, who is replacing an injured linebacker, McNeil, Gordon, Mitchell, and Kilpak. Kilpak, another great player, All-Valley, number 7 for the Bulldogs.
2nd and 9 from the 26-yard line for the Golden Hurricane. The handoff comes to Kenny Lacy. He's across the 30-yard line, and it'll be picked up by about 4 as Marvin.
Lacy now at the 500 mark on the season with that gain of 5 yards. 104 for 500 yards. Gunner, of course, the 8th leading rusher in the country.
Lacy, number 4 on the 2U career rushing chart. Again, they move Steinauer over to the top on the left. And on comes to number 22, Michael Gunner. Gunner's on his feet at the 50. He's to the 40-yard line. Beautiful cut back at the 32. Great run by Gunner and a block by Abramowitz.
They're going to give Gunner 48 yards on the carry. Watch it on the replay. Ken Lacy swings right. Gunner cutting back. Great move there. Another great move. And now he's going to get some downfield blocking. Look at Gunner turn it on as he outruns. C.J. McNeil makes another great cutback. It takes 3 of them to bring him down.
Back to action, the Golden Hurricane on the move on a 1st and 10. Ken Lacy, the ball carrier. Lacy starts.
Skip asked. Those numbers don't tell the story.
Weather conditions, it's 57 degrees, 42% humidity, and TU has a 7-mile-an-hour wind to their back. Here's Ast on the keeper at the line of scrimmage at the 18, and maybe one, certainly no more, as he is taken down. James Markert is back there covering.
Doesn't do anything silly when he's got the football out on the corner like that.
Third and six for the Golden Hurricanes. Steinauer reversing position, coming to the tight end right. Give it to DeLacy. He's on his feet. He's got the first down at the 10. He tries to dive to the end zone. Touchdown! Kenny Lacy scores a touchdown in the first 4 minutes of the ball game from the 17-yard line, and the Golden Hurricane has broken on top.
Kenny didn't quite run that fast, but he did make a great cut. Now watch him dive for the goal line. He stumbles, but he keeps the knee. Actually, the knee hit at the 2-yard line. They give him the touchdown anyway. Hurricane up by 6.
Extra point now by Stu Crum. He's only missed one in his college career. The kick is up, and it is good. 10 minutes, Bob, 31 seconds left to go in the first period, and TU marches almost the length of the field. There you see the score. The Golden Hurricane on top out of 1,000 or so, a 71-yard drive.
Here's the touchdown run again. Look at all that running room. He goes right around Kilpak, then gets by McNeil and stumbles.
75 yards, 2 minutes, 14 seconds is all it took. The Golden Hurricane to move down the field. Here's Stu Crum kicking off, and it's a beauty. All the way back in the end zone, number 23, Mike Williams, to the very close.
Just as they did last year in the 59-6 blowout at Skelly Stadium.
Two wide receivers, both to the right side of the line. The handoff comes to Ware. Ware runs a little counter and also runs into Blake Bjorkman. And we'll get on the ground, a 9.1 as a receiver. Yagelski, the quarterback. TU doing a little shifting now defensively. Drake putting a lot of people in motion, and TU's got to react by coverage. Here's Yagelski back to throw, tosses it complete at the 40-yard line, and then down to the other 40 to Tom Garrity. And he is out of bounds, but not before a big gain driven out by Brian Burroughs, and the homecoming crowd here at Drake Stadium reacts.
Here's the replay. Yagelski throws the ball 25 times a game. He'll test the TU secondary that time. Great job as they got around Kelly Beasley, and having to come to make the play all the way from his linebacker spot was Brian.
Yagelski hands it off to the running back, Holt, for the first time. Tommy Holt from Dubuque, Iowa, 5'11", 207, and a junior, also averaging 4.
Tommy Holt, by the way, has a 3.7 grade average, a pre-med major, so he's no dummy.
There's a play action. Yagelski's back. He's still got to hurry. Tosses it across and completes it to Jeff Hall, number 40.
He fumbled the football, and the Hurricane have come up with it. We'll have to check to see who picked it up for Tulsa, but the ball has been spotted at about the 16-yard line. Tulsa gets the football. Here it is on the replay. We'll watch it happen. Just a good, solid tackle by the Hurricane number 41.
Tony Buford. St. Louis, the freshman, 6'2", yeah, and 210.
And the coverage by Blake Bjorkman, who's already got 2 interceptions this year. So TU takes advantage of a turnover.
Golden Hurricane already leading. Here's a big hole for Kenny Lacy, the 25, across the 30 to the 31-yard.
A great ball player who injured his ankle last week in the loss to Nebraska-Omaha.
Hand off up to near the 35-yard line. Golden Hurricane keeping the ball.
Passing Sherman Johnson, a teammate of his a couple of years ago.
Second and 7 from the 35-yard line. TU with a back split, skip pass to quarterback Michael Gunner in trouble. And Gunner is going to be stacked up for maybe perhaps a gain of 1.
Two great friends who spent a lot of time before the ball game together. I don't think I've ever seen two coaches spend more time at the center of the field just talking over old times and when they're going to play next year and maybe a golf game later on.
Third and 5, 7:55 left to go in the first period. TU leading 7-0 on a touchdown by Kenny Lacy. Hand off to Kenny Lacy and nothing there. And Yarder against New Mexico State, averaging 41.6. Look at that beautiful catch. Sends Dave Kilpak back at the 15-yard line, and Kilpak gets to the 21 and driven out. Wide receiver coming out to the right side. They've got Williams and Hill in the ballgame. Moving the end, Jarity on the other side. Here comes a pass out to number 23, Mike Williams. And he's got it and then out of bounds at the 26th. First period, Golden Hurricane, very short drive, but 75 yards, a little better than 2 minutes for the score. There's a handoff to Tommy Holt, number 38, with a good second effort to get the first down to the 35-yard line. Holt's a pre-med student. His father played at Drake in the 50s.
We haven't seen him get the ball since.
But a man on the wing right to hand off counter to Ware. Baxter split. Dunsmore moves to the tight end spot of the right side. He's number 40. Back is Yagelski to throw. Across the middle, beautiful swing, completes the pass. And all the way down to the 44-yard line to number 33, Carlos Renick-Lenard. Talking about standing ball games this year. The handoff to Ware. Ware from the 43, and that's about where he ends up. Second and 10 now. Dunsmore moves back over, tight end right. That means TU's got a shift. Now they put a man over, and it's really wearing out some of the secondary. Pass is complete just shy of the 35-yard line to Bob Grant. From Scranton by way of Illinois, as you saw on the graphic. There's a little floater out to number 40, Dunsmore, and Dunsmore. Line of scrimmage now is at 26-yard line. Drake moving first and 10. Here comes Ware. Inside the 25, Timmy Gibbs, number 23, is just getting worn out by all of the shifting and people in motion. There's the ball almost intercepted by Brian from the Public Broadcasting System of Iowa. Glad to have their facilities, along with our producer, Mel Elzia. Back to throw as Yagelski swings and tosses, and it's intercepted by number 43, Kelly Beasley, the free safety, and Beasley takes it back to the 25-yard line.
Kelly Beasley playing center field, gets his second of the year.
7-0, 3:53 left in the first period. The backs are split, wide receivers at both tops. The quarterback is Skip Ask. He rolls, he looks, he drills, it's too high. And number 24, Gary Woods.
Four long runs in that ball game. Four plays over 50 yards for the Hurricane in the 59-6 route.
There's Ask, hand off to Lacey. To the 32-yard line. Kenny
season.
Lacey and Phillips are the receivers. Baxter split and tight. Steinauer in at the tight end spot. Play action. Ass puts it up in the air, and a beautiful catch by Phillips. He was wide open between the lines. Don't forget tonight on 5-star at 10:30, OU and OSU from Norman. Ahead Lacey, and Lacey goes to about the 48 for a pickup of two on first down. 2 minutes, 40 seconds left in the first quarter.
Youngster with dad, and there's Coach Chuck Shelton, who's done a marvelous job here at Drake. You know, there's not a lot of money for football here, and again, they're the number three program in the state. There's line coach Joe Hollis of the Golden Hurricane. Joe's done a great job with the offensive line. He's being given much of the credit for the surge of this running game. TU has never had a running game like they've had this year.
It's Haskell, the keeper, comes around the left side of the out to the 40, across the 40, the 35, and down to the 33-yard line.
Skip the Bulldogs.
He looks much more comfortable when he's running the football than when he's passing it. 1:54 left in the period. TU with another first down. There's a drop play to Lacey, and he's in big trouble, folks. He's going to be going for a loss all the way back to the 42. 17, second down. 1:14 left in the first period. Ast is back to throw. Lets it go and completes it across the 25-yard line to Gary Woods.
Great catch by Woods going low. Remember, he's a converted running back. Dunnigan helping out on the tackle. We'll see it again. Ast sets up well in the pocket. Again, he just has not been real comfortable throwing the football. Nice catch by Woods. The Hurricane driving inside the 30.
Third down and two. They got 15 of the 17 that they needed. Here comes a pitch back to Gunner. Gunner is taken care of shy of the 25-yard line, which was the line of scrimmage. It'll be fourth and about three.
Stu Crum will probably be called on the ground.
Stu Crum, the rush will be coming. There it is. There's the kick by Stu. It is up in the air. It is heading. It is good. Beautiful kick from the left side of the field. He had to angle that one through. Timeout with just 2 seconds left to go in the first quarter with the score now. The Golden Hurricane 10, Drake nothing.
Drake
Stadium in Des Moines. There's the scoring drive, 9 plays, pit fours down, just a little better than 6 minutes.
A couple of good catches in that drive by Phillips and by Gary Woods. So the Hurricane trying to prove they can throw the football.
Stu kicking off, number 23, Michael Williams back at the 5-yard line. He's got good speed across the 20 and out of bounds at the 30-yard line. With the score, the Golden Hurricane of the University of Tulsa, 10, and the Drake Bulldogs on homecoming, nothing. 10-point deficit to make up. They've got 10 yards from where they would have had at the 20. Moving the tight end off to the opposite side. Gary Yagelski is at the quarterback. Now they put a man in motion back the other way, and yeah, we'll get a procedure.
There's Jim Corbin. John
Holt and Ware are the running backs. Yagelski's back in the pocket, throws across the middle. That one's up for grabs. Ford can't get
difference to him. They're playing great football.
Bob Graff comes out as a wide receiver left. Again, Dunsmore, tight end, moved to the opposite side. Now they put number 23, Mike Williams, in motion. Yagelski's looking around. He's got Williams. He's going to overshoot him, though, way over his head. And also the second quarter. 14:46 left to go to halftime. We're just a couple of seconds into the second period. Yagelski's back and pumping and throwing and completes the pass to, I thought it was Mike Williams. Brent Dennis, averaging 7.4, is standing ready to receive the kick from the punter. Up in the air and taken back at the 22-yard line by Dennis, to the 25, to the 30. Oh, gets on his feet still and almost up to the 40-yard line, out at the 37.
Nice hit by Carlos Foster, but Brent Dennis spun away from all MVC academically as well.
Hurricane punt return last year against this great Bulldog ball club. David Hertzey's in the lineup now. Pitchback comes to Gunner. He's at the 40 and down to the 43-yard line. Michael Gunner stopped by Dave Kilpak to free safety.
You mentioned that great punt return.
David Hertzey moves in motion. Tight end moves to the opposite side. Here's the option. Pitchback is taken right out from under him by number. Chicago, Estes and Watson in the lineup. Long count by the quarterback, Ast. He'll dump it off to Gunner, and Gunner will take it up to the 48-yard line.
Nice check of a homecoming for him to get back up here.
There's a pitch to Gunner. Gunner running out of the power slot, takes it up near the 45-yard line when he is hit by Jeff Hall, number 41. Hall, a former running back and also a former tight end. He's from Ankeny, Iowa.
They decided to make a linebacker out of him. He adjusted very quickly, made a good play there.
Second and 5 with a back split, but they're in pretty close to each other. Kenny Lacy across the 45. Lacy had 14, almost 100 between them. Count for Ast, keeps it after faking the Gunner. And he is across the 45, down to the 38-yard line.
End zone against the wind.
Ware in the first quarter only had 15 yards, incidentally. They moved Hersey off to the tight end spot right. Play action, and he went down and had no time to do anything. And loss of 7, second and 17 from the 44-yard line. 10:48 left to halftime. Tulsa leading 10 to nothing. Hand off coming to Kenny Lacy, and nothing there for Kenny. Gilliland still a good defensive player, though, so they've got good competition at that left defensive end spot. Third and 16. Here's a pass across the middle, and it is incomplete, intended for number 2, Glenn Watson, and broken up by Jeff Hall, who was...
He hit one for 49 his last time out.
Kilpak and Barrett are deep. It's going to be a fair catch called by Chuck Barrett, Calumet City, Illinois. And it is down there. The Golden Hurricane will have it from the 11-yard
line in a moment.
Here comes Drake from just a little beyond the 10-yard line. They give it to Ware, and Ware's to the 20. Amaro Ware needing 32 yards, and he's getting pretty close to it now. They think they'll stop the ball game and give him the game ball when indeed he breaks the record.
Yeah, we'll know when he does it because they'll shut things down. Michigan leads Northwestern. No surprise there at all. 14-0 there in the second quarter.
Second and one from the 20-yard line. Again, they have a lot of movement. They're going to throw on second and one. Maybe a surprise, and the pass is caught by Mike Williams, number 23. There's Mike. Get 37 catches for five
this year. Have.
We're looking for an offensive ball game. We've seen it, although Drake hasn't scored. Straight ahead to Tommy Holt, the running back, and Holt crosses the 40-yard line.
Drake has moved the ball, as you indicated.
8:37 left to halftime. Play action. They're going to throw it again. He goes the opposite way. Yagelski fires it and completes it. Bob Kraft has split end. There's the split end from Scranton, averaging
to Jeff Woodruff.
See the glasses underneath the helmet. 8:12 left to go. Oh, good hit at the line on Amaro Ware. Ware went in amongst the big boys and got hit.
Sound back up. Arkansas beats Houston in the fourth, 35-3. I imagine everybody will know that score ahead of time.
In motion for Drake. They are looking. Yagelski's in trouble and no time to swing.
Going to throw the football.
Yeah, their offensive and defensive line is taking a little bit of heat this year. Yagelski with not much time again as he tries to swing it out to the next first down. Tommy Miller, number 39, will go back to punt, puts a pretty good one up in the air, and Dennis sees it go over his head into the end zone. Good decoy by Brent Dennis, and nobody back for Drake, and once it hit the ground, it quickly
started to take control of the trenches, and Tulsa's backs have not been able to get loose since that first drive when the Hurricane drove to score.
Gunner and Lacey, it goes to Lacey, big hole across the 40-yard line, and he'll be better than a 20-yard gain, and all the way out to the free safety, Dave Kilpak.
Yard day.
And off comes to Gunner this time. He'll run a counter across the 50-yard line. Second and less than 2 yards.
I don't think anybody's worked any harder than John Kaspersky and David Pearson on the right side, or on the left side, rather, to help out TU.
They're going to throw on second and two. Ass puts it up for Phillips, and it's intercepted by number five, C.J. McNeil. McNeil, a cornerback who plays Summit. Strong safety, and he pulled it down.
For Skip Ast, only his third interception of the season.
McNeil Bob surgery last year, and in the spring he broke his nose, so he's had some problems. Here's Yagelski again. He's quickly throws it, almost picked off by Cooper, and it is caught by Bob Graff. Well, he got rid of that football.
The distraction.
Second and two from the 18-yard line. 5:59 left to go in the first half. Man in motion is Jarity, number 88. And nothing there. Third down and one. Straight ahead it goes, and as they unpile near the
go for it, and he's a little upset that they're not.
Aroma of hamburgers, Bob, filling the booth.
You guys, nothing but food. Nothing but food you think about. Almost blocked as he gets it away. Deep back is Dennis.
Tony Buford almost got Miller. Dennis at the 38, trying to find some room, and gets it to the 45-yard line, and he gets about 8 yards. Second down and eight, 4:32. TU leading 10-0. We'd like to get on the boards one more time. Ast has two men out to the right side. He fires it to number 87, Keith Estes, the flanker. Estes stays in the ball game to the right side. Ast looks the other way and throws. Great catch by Glenn Watson, number two.
Watson, the public relations major.
Studying in Bixby. Here's Woods coming in motion. Keeper by Ass behind Lacey to the 20-yard line and all the way down to the 10 for a Golden Hurricane motion. There's a pitch back to Gunner. He follows Lacey, but not able to do it. And Ted Faunus, number 42.
10 points is easy to come back from. 17 is a whole nother ballgame.
Drake's won 18 ball games in the last 2 years. Here's Ast to the 8-yard line. Just followed him all the way around. Panazzo and also Dunnigan. And
they might want to throw to the backs this time. Let's see what Skipper calls right here.
Golden Hurricane can get a first down without a touchdown. Now they have two wide receivers coming up, but he's going the other way with it, and he is hit as he gets to the six-yard line.
Skip was looking for the tight end, Kurt Steinhauer, and Steinhauer was open in the back of the end zone. Skipper could not. The only thing that'll bother him at all is the angle, but he even likes the way that goes, as he has been hooking him to the left when he's been missing him this year. Here we go.
Scott Brown is holding. The kick is up in the air, and it is good, and Stu Crum has just broken the record.
The new Missouri Valley Conference all-time career field goal kicker, Stu Crum of the Hurricane. Tulsa leads by 13.
Experience and confidence are important qualities.
McNeil, just shy of the 20-yard line, and he propels himself beyond the 30 and goes out of bounds. So the Drake Bulldogs now trying to get on the scoreboard has 1 minute and 18 seconds.
Defense linebackers, they're going to just play umbrella here. They'll give up some yards and try not to give up six.
Dunsmore moves over tight end the other side. Once again, they put Williams in motion. A lot of people moving. Quicker out to Williams. He's got it complete, and he's down to the 50-yard line.
Williams is a flyer.
They did that all in just 2 seconds. Now it's down to 107 and counting. Yagelski looks for the sideline. It's deflected and intercepted by Bob Babich. Brian Bruner
gets to spend the night at home.
59 seconds now. Tulsa has 49 yards to go to try to get on the scoreboard once again. Here's a play action back and a throw to Lacey at the 40. Lacey dances along the sidelines, and they say he went out at the. There's 52 seconds left. Woods and Phillips in as receivers. Both are split out. Asked has thrown the ball very well. There's another play action fake to Gunner. Lets it go across the middle to Phillips at the 20-yard line. Runs into the free safety kill pack, but his ball. 33 seconds left to go from the 18-yard line. Kenny Lacey goes to the 15, and he's down to the 14. Hurricane second and seven with 25 seconds to go. Ask has a couple of people out. Drills a pass incomplete. Intended for number 24, Gary Woods. And
Oklahoma leads Oklahoma State. 2 minutes left in the half down in Norman. Sooners 13-3.
Third and seven. Here's the big one for Ast, or else perhaps another field goal. Here's Lacey, touchdown! Second one of the ball game for Kenny Lacey.
Great fake, super fake by Skip Ast. He gives the ball to Lacey. There you see the Tulsa fans. TU puts one on the board before halftime. A massive touchdown, extremely important. And because now Drake is going to have to completely regroup. Here we'll see it on the replay. Watch Skip Ast carry out the fake. There's the play to Lacey. He just follows his tight end Steinhauer all the way to the five. He just hid behind Steinhauer and then got the touchdown. Stu Crum's kick.
Stu has now taken a 20-0 lead.
Again, the important 9 yards did it in 44 seconds. I'd like to have them as my fire department, let me tell you.
Stu Crum is 2 out of 2 in extra points in the ball game, and he's 2 out of 2 in field goals, and he kicks off. Up in the air, taken in the middle at the 18-yard line by Mike Williams, number 23, and he gets to the 29 before driven.
The key and start the Hurricane offense. It goes in and scores. Well, and we'll also take a look at half at the homecoming activities here at Drake.
There's the bomb, Yagelski, and there's a flag thrown. That could be offensive interference. Number 23, Mike Williams, out on the coverage with Brent Dennis, number 58.
Should Yagelski winds up. Throws the ball like Charlie Moore did in the World Series, right on a line, and you already saw, if you're watching the bottom of your screen, the push-off. That's why Brent Dennis, sometimes in big chunks, they average giving up 377 yards.
Down counts, second down.
All right, you heard it.
First and 24, they go with a running play to Ware to get him some yards, and he comes out to the 19, that's the end of the first half. So the girl in Hurricane 31 mark in the first quarter, 2 seconds in the first period. Bob, of which we mentioned the time of possession we didn't talk about, 18:05 to 11:55. That's a pretty good margin. And the turnovers, 3-1 Drake. Therein lies much of the story.
A top 20-0 over the Drake Bulldogs, and TU will get the football to start the second half to add insult to injury.
Brad Anderson, number 75, kicking off for the first time. Benny May, Kirk Phillips will be receiving. 20-0 is the score on Five Star Cable Sports. Glad to have you with us live. Benny May at the 2-yard line. Benny's to the 10, to the 15. Turns it at the 18-yard line.
Quarterback. quarterback, Gunner, and Lacey behind him, and Keith Estes wide.
Glenn Watson is in the ball game. As Gunner, and about 2 yards, as Bob had mentioned. Second down and 7 yards to go. Estes comes in motion. They're going to go run it to the opposite side, pitching it to Gunner. He's to the 30. Gunner's to the 35, to the 40. He's to the 50-yard line. He's got a good blocker down in front of him, and he is gone.
Kiss him goodbye.
80 yards. And a touchdown for the Golden Hurricane.
Michael Gunner is something else.
He got a couple of good blocks, not no great blocks, but just took advantage of it and rambled 80 yards for a first touchdown of the afternoon for Michael Gunner and the Golden Hurricanes third.
Needless to say, Michael Gunner now over the 100-yard mark for the day. 151 yards in 10 carries. That's a 15-yard average, and you can play for anybody with an average like that.
Here's Stu Crum putting it through for the third time in this ball game, and the Golden Hurricane strikes with 1:23 left in the half, 15 seconds left in the half, and then in the first 50 seconds of this period.
Halfway down the field, a super cut. He leaves two good defensive backs in the dust, McNeil and Gordon, and there he's off to the races. Nobody is going to catch Michael Gunner from behind in the Missouri Valley. He waltzes into the end zone. And it's 27 to nothing.
Seconds left to go.
And for halftime, this was a 50-second drive.
Here's the kick by Crum, and it is a boomer against a 7-mile-an-hour wind, taken at the end zone, and a little bit of a hesitation, but not much. Williams downs it, will come out to the 20.
Williams,
the longest run of the season for a score by Gunner, previously was 79 against Air Force in the opening game. Here's the draw to Ware. He is the new rushing leader in the history of Drake. He needed
the ball. Now they're going to do it. And the linemen, I tell you what, the linemen are patting him on the back. I know he's got some linemen to pat on the back himself. You don't do it without the guys up front. Amaro Ware getting his hand shaken by a couple of the Hurricane. The record is his. He comes over to hand the ball to Chuck Shelton and then to a trainer. Amaro Ware coming out of the ball game. They're going to make him come out for one play. Well, now they decide they can go ahead and send him back on.
Quite pick up the first down. He got 9 yards on the play. They're going to throw on second and one. Yagelski across the middle. Wide open is Garrity. And for the all-time Valley record also. Gunter might be challenging that at one time. Here comes the run across the 45-yard line. Amaro Ware once again. 23, who's been in motion most of the day. Now they put the tight end Dunsmore sliding the other side. He's a good ball player. Yagelski throws, completes the pass to Ware. Amaro Ware to the 30-yard line and goes across the 25 down to the 23. Robert Estes trying to get on the board. This is the closest they've been. A sack.
Way to a 1,000-yard season with 847.
Second and 12. Yagelski's in trouble again. He's not getting that time to throw. The ball is loose. And it's going to be taken back by Yagelski, Blankenship, and especially Bob Babich, number 60. This is a big play, and you know Yagelski's going to put it in the air now. They got receivers all over the place. Here's Yagelski back, throws it quickly, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Johnny Cooper, and Cooper's up to the 35.
New quarterback for the Golden Hurricane, Scotty Brown.
Also, Johnny Horton and Eddie Hamilton. Here's the handoff to Hamilton, and he fumbles it and falls on it at the 35. And only lost one on the play. Kirk Phillips comes out as a wide receiver. There you see 16-23 is running backs. Brown's going to throw. It's deflected at the line of scrimmage by
Hurricane. He was 3 of 9 on the season coming in, so he's now 3 of 10.
36 total yards passing. Play action, he'll go to the opposite side, throws it, and it's deflected and intercepted by number 7, Dave Kilpak, the free safety.
He's made all-conference academically and on the field.
He has 8 tackles, or had 8 tackles, against TU in last year's ball game at Skelly. That one in
wants to get those points back quickly, and like you say, maybe too quickly.
And Drake is warming up the reserve quarterback on the sidelines. Greg Ostrowski. Again, he throws it quickly, although he had a pretty good rush put on him by Timmy Gibbs. His overall record is 29-33. Yagelski rolls to the opposite side, lets it go, and it's in and out of the grip of Bob Graff.
What a hit by Kelly.
Kick up in the air. Dennis takes it back at the 5-yard line and thrown back to the 3-yard line.
The Bulldog fans with a little something to cheer about as their defense puts Tulsa way, way back. We'll see if the Hurricane come out with the first unit offense. We're in the third quarter. Oklahoma leading Oklahoma State 13-6, and Scott Brown having some trouble getting away
to the 5-yard line and then driven back. That last punt, by the way, by 5-yard line, second and 10. The running backs, Horton and Hamilton. Pitchback coming to Johnny Horton, number 33. Johnny will give him a little extra breathing room. Close Big Ten game this afternoon, 29-28. Third down and 5 from the 10-yard line. Scotty Brown just shoved the ball into the belly of Johnny Horton, and Johnny goes out to the 11. He says, here, you see a yard and a half deep. Cook averaging 41.6 for the year, kicking, and he had his feet came right out from under him. No flag thrown. The ball hits, takes a little bit of a Drake bounce. Now it's taking a TU bounce, and it's going to go back beyond the 45-yard line to very near the 46.
Who was the guy who
left in the third period? Drake with pretty good field position down to the TU 46 to start things off. Graff goes in motion. Here's Ware with it. Ware's across the 45 to the 44, where his forward progress is stopped by Brussey offense. TU 381, Drake 278, a difference of 103 yards. Second and 7. Here's the throw to the sideline, and it is caught by number 23, Mike Williams. Against Nebraska Omaha last week, Williams had 10 catches in one ballgame. Here's a pass to Williams, and he brings it to the 30. There's the backs remaining the same. Holden Ware behind Yagelski. Yagelski goes back, looks over the top of Holt, now fires the other way, and a beautiful catch by Mike Williams. Third one in a row for Williams. 10 from the 21. They give it to Ware. He tries to get outside and
shove one in and show Tulsa they can score. They're inside the 20 for the first time today.
Yagelski fires quickly to Williams, fourth in a row. And Williams out of bounds at the 6-8.
Mike Williams' numbers, not only as a pass catcher, but as a returner.
I got 965. That's 35 short of 1,000, and the flags for Ron Zetcher from Chesterfield. Here's the throw. That's going to be, almost caught. I thought it was out of bounds when he first threw
catch.
Fourth and 6 from the 17. Look for Yagelski to go to the air. He's barking the signals up. Perhaps to an audible as he looks over the defense. He rolls left. They got good coverage on him, and it's incomplete, and TU will take over on downs. Star William Oliver is the new quarterback in, the third quarterback of the ball game. Ken Lacy is back in as a running back. You see Kenny there.
Johnny Horton, 33, along with him. And there you see the guy who made 13-6.
Second and 8 from the 19-yard line. Long count by Oliver, fakes the pitch, keeps it, and he's tackled again by Barnett. There's a good shot of number 4. He turns play action and throws it, and it's dropped out in the open by number 82, David Hersey. Hersey, 2 catches, 30.
And again, inside his own 10-yard line, he punted from the end zone his last time.
Kick is up in the air, and number 7 is back there. Kilpak takes it about the 37. Kilpak then back driven to the 35-yard line. Channel 17, the 5-star cable sports network. Hand off to Ware, number 26, across the 40 out to the 45. Bear Merrill.
9. OSU has just kicked a field goal. Oklahoma leads 13-9, third quarter at Norman.
Here's Yagelski back to throw. No, sir. Wrapped up by Joe Dick.
Getting a chance to look at some people before the big one next week at Wichita.
Again, you don't want to get anybody hurt in a route like this. Here's a pass across the middle. It's complete to Ware at the 45. He's across the 50, down to the 47 on the tackle by Buford. Today again, 3-0 over Southern Illinois. Here's the pass across. It's complete to Bob Graff, another fine receiver. Downs are even, and haven't we had a lot of first downs? 30 of them, and we still have 3:32 left to go in the third quarter. There's number 38, Tommy Holtz, been a long time.
And, of course, Drake with 15 first downs and nothing to show for it.
Looking for Graff again. Flags are thrown. Yagelski throws it up, and it is out of bounds.
Chuck's over on a different phone ordering out for Chinese food. He's let this one get away from him.
Yagelski's got about four receivers out, and nobody's there, so he's going to take it around the other side. Misdirected inside the 20, and he's out to the 18-yard line.
Ever see the defense? First and 10 Bulldogs, as you were about to say.
It's on the 17-yard line. Where? Nothing. At just 53 yards in the first half, so they really haven't added anything to it. Second and 11 from the 18-yard line. Yagelski goes and throws and completes it inside the 10-yard line to the
end goal. For the Drake Bulldogs, their most serious effort of the ball game.
Backs are split. Going to go with the run play and straight ahead inside the 5-yard.
We're looking for 23 right there. We'll see if Tulsa can do it again here.
Warren Holt, the keeper by Yagelski, touchdown. Quarterback went in over his left guard and turned left between the guard and the top. In motion is Williams. Yagelski's going the opposite side. He throws, and it's incomplete. Intended for the tailback.
Turnover. They might be able to make something happen before it's all over. 11 plays, 64-yard drive, and 4:28. Well engineered by quarterback Gary Yagelski.
William Oliver is back in at quarterback. Kenny Lacy and Eddie Hamilton are the running backs. Here's Lacy up to the 18 for a loss of two. Just couldn't. Just 8 seconds to the end of the third period. Pat Maley is the center. Ball is loose, but Lacy gets it back again. Look at Lacy.
Watch Lacy get this bounce.
The hit by Jeff Hall, number 41, at the end of three quarters. It's Tulsa 27 and Drake 6.
That Oklahoma-Oklahoma State game, 13-9. They're late in the third quarter down in Norman. Iowa State and Colorado, big game for these people, 7-7 in the second quarter.
Fourth and final period, TU facing a third and 6 from their own 24-yard line. Woods comes in motion. Pitch to the opposite side, Kenny Lacy, and Lacy's to the 25-yard line, gains one, stopped again by Mark Panazzo.
Panazzo again.
Yard line where he'll boot it. Boots it from the 15. It's a little wobbly. Cook is down. There's a flag. That'll be roughing the kicker, and none of this will matter.
Play. You watch the ball go up. Now watch him get flattened right at the bottom of your screen. He's in midair. And boom.
To you from the 41-yard line. Oliver scrambling. A late pitch out to number 16.
That wasn't him, see? And then Corbin comes in, calls it right.
First and 10 from the 39. William Oliver has been in there for some time now. He's going to the opposite side, lets it go, throws it too high. Number 80 did not have a chance. Steinauer. Seconds left in the ballgame. We're just 52 seconds into the fourth and final period. TU's moving from the 39, second and 10.
Drake had the ball for more than 10 minutes of that third quarter. Here's the reverse.
Yeah, the reverse, and it's an end reverse. Kirk Phillips goes left side, penalty flag is thrown, and he's to the 40-yard.
For the Bulldogs.
For TU making some personnel changes. Steinauer is out, Phillips is out. Watson's in. Oliver back, straight back in the pocket and lets it go across the middle, and it is deflected by number 57, Clifford Dunthings over. Now Woods and Phillips back in the ball game. It's a third and 20, so they want the fleet-footed runners in. Here's Oliver throwing long, and that will be nearly intercepted by Robert. Cook will boot it from the 40-yard line. Beautiful spiral kick over the head, but a little too long, and in the end zone, Benny May was flying down to control their own destiny. Here's Yagelski straight back, pumps, throws a little screen out to Amaro Ware. Ware comes out of the secondary to the 30-yard line, stopped by Brian Bruner
for the University of Tulsa. John, 12 NFL selections.
And TU just 56 seconds more in the ball possession time also. Yagelski back on second and one, again throwing. He loves to throw. Has not played in the second half. Williams in motion. Yagelski hands it off. Up the middle to Amaro Ware. Well, by both of those performers. Yagelski rolling left. Firing. And it's incomplete. At the top of your screen, Graff and Williams. Yagelski's put it up just about every time now. Throws it intended for the tight end Dunsmore. And there's a penalty flag coming.
Not so much upset the call was made, but that it took so long to make it. Timmy Gibbs. As Yagelski today, 24 out of 35 for over 300 yards. But then those three INTs really hurt him.
Yagelski barking out the calls out so everybody can hear. He goes back and throws quickly, and it's incomplete this time. They're going to lose Dunsmore also. And, of course, where? Yagelski in trouble. Still has plenty of time. It is deflected by...
Everybody, including the coaching staff and the cheerleaders.
Yagelski drops back, tosses it out to Ware. Ware takes off and trips and falls. A flag is down.
Drake first down one way or the other.
There's a handoff to Ware. He's inside the 30-yard line. Even the scoreboard had it marked from the 30. Yagelski back again. The ball knocked away. Number 9.
415 to 397. But you don't play the game with.
We'll be talking about throughout the week as they prepare for Wichita State. Third and four from the 28. Amaro Ware on his feet driving for the first down and looks like he's got it. They're going to go over to Dunsmore, the tight end. He's to the 20 and he's up to the 16-yard line before. Here's Ware, big hole to the 10-yard line. Five touchdown, Drake. Amaro Ware, a 16-yard touchdown. There he is, Amaro. His 10th touchdown. He is now scoring
within 13 and lots of time left to go. Drake could make a ball game of it.
Yagelski going back. Pumping and throwing, and it is knocked away by Brent Dennis, number 15. So we have a timeout with 10 minutes, 20 seconds left in the football game, and it's getting a little close. 27 for the Golden Hurricane, 12 for the Drake Bulldogs.
Expecting the onside kick, quarterback Scott Brown is in the middle of the Tulsa line. Hersey on one end, all up backs, nine men up front for Tulsa.
There's the kickoff by Brad Anderson, taken by Phillips at the 11. It's through across the 20. The ball's loose, and Drake's got it. Drake's got the football at the 22-yard line.
Tulsa may have put one in their pocket a little early. The big, big turnover. Banasek picks it up, and these are some happy Drake Bulldogs. They are not out of it yet. All number 41.
I said Drake had to score three more times. That's not really correct.
No.
They can score twice and get two both times.
Your arithmetic is bad as mine.
That's
today.
Correct. And here comes Ware. And Ware is at the 15-yard line and downed inside the 15. And
look to do.
First and 10 from the 23-yard line. Here's Amaro Ware sweeping outside. He's to the 15 and up. What's the score? Yagelski off to Holt. He's inside the five, down to the 4-yard line. Drake Bulldogs, second and two from the three. Here's Ware, down to the two and inside the two. Center of the line, Brian Bruner, Kevin Lilly. Joe Blankenship in from the end spot. There is Amaro Ware, who has gone over the all-time record. He only had 54 yards. Yards last year against Colson. He's a freshman, didn't score that much for them. Touchdown. Amaro Ware has scored his second TD, and he has
gotten it within a touchdown.
If they don't, then they do have to score two more times.
A very big play right
here. This is critical for Drake. Yagelski fakes it. He's in trouble. Doesn't make it. So
he has not seen any action.
Back. Ready for the kick from Brad Anderson. Phillips fumbled the last one that put TU in a hole. Here's the kick. They'll probably go right to him. It's Phillips again. This is the 16-yard line to the 20, 25. He's to the 30-yard line and then driven down at the 31. So TU will play.
Drake has controlled most of the second half. Tulsa getting an early third quarter touchdown. As a matter of fact, in the first 50 seconds of the quarter, when Gunner ran 80 yards, that's the last time he played.
TU only got one first down in the third quarter and have not gotten any, I don't think, in this period.
Nope.
So one first down in 20 minutes of football. Here's Lacy, and he's just picked up the second one in the Tulsa at their own 44-yard line. 7:49 left in the game. Skip Ass, the quarterback from Phoenix, to Michael Gunner. His first carry of the second half as he's across the 45 to the 47-yard line.
It is threatening to happen something like that here again today.
Second and six from the 48. Skip Bass tries to do something with it. He gives it to Lacy, and he's across midfield, stopped by Mark Pedazzo.
Yagelski in.
He's been sacked three times, though, and he's thrown three interceptions. In motion, Hersey. Long count asked. In motion was Estes, rather, and nothing.
Great defensive stand by the Bulldogs, and they're going to get the football back. You see him on the sidelines.
TU quickly got a first down with Lacy, and then once again couldn't move it. So really, well, they got a couple of minutes off the clock. It started at 8:15. It's now 6:03. TU leading by 9, and there's a penalty flag, and that's going to be against Drake, and that will give TU the first down.
Critical mistake by the Bulldogs. Victor Jambron, he's a backup nose guard, gets called, and they're going to call it against Tulsa. They're going to say he was drawn off. Oh, I want to see that one again. Bone chipped in his ankle, the deep snapper for Tulsa.
Now it's 4th and 7, so the punt will come. Cook, a beauty. Boy, look at the hang time on that one. There'll be no run back, and the ball hits the ground at the 7-yard line, and then it's in the end zone in just a fraction of a second later. So Drake, Maryland, third quarter, 32-6 over Duke. Purdue beat Michigan State today, 24-21. Here's Yagelski. He's back to throw. Got plenty of time, lets it go. It's incomplete. Graff can't get it. Second down and 10 from the 20-yard line. Yagelski going to give it off to Ware, and Ware's 2 yards, no more. At 27 to nothing at one time. Now 27-18, and the Bulldogs with the football. Dunsmore lines up tight end other side. Williams goes in motion to the top of your screen. The quarterback, Yagelski, drops back and lets it go, and it's incomplete. Intended for Dunsmore. Miller takes the snap and lets it go from the 12-yard line. Fair catch, Brent Dennis at the 47.
He caught that one up on his left shoulder. The starters very early in the third quarter with that 27 to nothing lead. Didn't want to run it up on his friend Chuck, and certainly hasn't.
There's Gunner, 3 yards to the 44. Clifford Dunnigan, number 57.
The Drake Bulldogs.
Second and 7 from the 43. 4:25 left in the ball game. Takes it to Gunner. Ass keeps it. Dives to the 39-yard line. He is still 3 yards shy of a.
Tulsa would rather have the first down.
Long count by Ass. They use as much of the clock as possible. Gunter with Lacy in front of him as a block. He got the first down to the 36-yard line. From the 35-yard line. Big first down picked up by Michael Gunner. Skip Ass fakes to, gives it to Gunner, and he gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Tulsa using.
Tulsa when they blasted them 59-6. Second and 10 from the 35. Ass to Lacy. Good second effort to the 30. I made mention a little bit ago of the 27, Iowa State, Colorado tied 14-14 at the half. Missouri leading Nebraska 7-3 at the half. Third and four from the 29.
Ast keeping the ball.
Ooh, hits a tackle. Made a good fake to Gunner as he took it to the 20-yard line. Other score, Ohio State over Indiana. Cincinnati 3, second quarter, UCLA and California tied at 14. Michigan beating Northwestern 49-14 in the fourth as the action continues and the clock ticks under 2 minutes. Stan surgery in the spring, but has come back to back Marlo Barnett at left defensive tackle.
Gunner now at around the 180-yard mark. And there's
Gunner,
190.
He is to the 1 yard line. Did not quite get in, as you see it.
Stepping high. Finally tripped up by number nine, by Brian Gordon.
You see how close he got to a touchdown. He came down just on this side of the goal.
Interesting to see right here who TU gives the football to as Gary Woods comes out and bringing in the play is Estes. Sometimes Lacey and Gunner will talk to each other and says, you take the ball or I'll take the ball, and they make a decision from there. They're right in close to Skip Ast.
I'm just going to say, how about Ast himself? And he takes it up and did not make it.
Beat Wichita last year 52-21, scored 8 of the first 10 times.
Lacey and Gunner. Ast the quarterback. I think he'll probably hand it off to somebody this time. He pitches it to Gunner. Touchdown for Michael Gunner. Water coming just the 50 seconds in. And the extra point by Crum. Kick up. And it is good once again. So 48 seconds remaining. Score. He needed that one very badly. Not really, because forget tonight, OU, OSU at 10:30 on Five Star, Channel 17. Here's Stu Crum kicking. There's 48 seconds left in the ball game. Back in the end zone. He's going to run it out of there. Mike Williams from about 5 yards deep. Williams to the 20 and then to the 23, and that's where they'll play it.
The football club could have very easily have given up, thrown in the towel, and said, see you next week, but they did not want to give it up and made a heck of a ball game out of it.
Yagelski's going to throw it one more time, and it's not. Drake will be at West Texas State next week, and they host Wichita State. They finish up at Illinois State. Yagelski back, throwing on second and 10 from the 24, and completes it to Dunsmore, and is he wrapped up? 29-yard line. Yagelski's gone all the way at quarterback. Here it is to Jarity, number 88. Garrity will take it outside. They're going to be 2-6.
It's got to hurt Chuck Shelton a lot after back-to-back winning seasons. He will not have a winning season this year, and TU will after the last 10 seconds of this ball game. They will have both clinched.
Referee over there looking the situation over to determine whether it's a first down or not. And I guess they have determined that it isn't, but they're two more plays. 11 seconds is all that's left. The ball's at the 47. TU's leading 34-18. Led 20-0 at the half and 27-0 with just 50 seconds gone in the third period. Yagelski's back to throw, lets it go. Flag is down. Pass is completed to the 36 to Bob Graff. Final play of the ball game is upcoming, and Drake will try to go 47. They'll have everybody out. Time has expired, and so has the quarterback. And that's the end of the ball game with the final score, the Tulsa Golden Hurricane 34, Drake Bulldogs 18.
We'd like to thank our audio man, Vern Winter, for his great work in the ball game. 34-18 Tulsa. You see John Cooper and Chuck Shelton in the middle of the field.
Big ball game is next Saturday afternoon from Wichita State, Cessna Stadium over there. Then it's two home games after that. The Golden Hurricane off to a great start as they have a 6-1 record. But Bob, next week is the big one. The touchdowns for the Golden Hurricane coming in this one. Kenny Lacey, Michael Gunter. And Michael Gunter a second time. Lacey from 17, Gunter from 80, Gunter from 1.